What's up, guys? It's Mr. MoggleX here, and welcome to the first part of my Super Mario World Let's Play. So I just start things off with the first level of the game. Actually, let's go to Yoshi's Crib real quick. Let's do a MTV Cribs episode. Oh shit, Yoshi's Crib's tight. Sorry, I'm not home. Damn shame, Yosh. Damn shame. Should have been home. Could have done an MTV's Cribs episode and stuff. That'd be crazy. Oh well, I guess another time, Yosh. And this is Super Mario World. With, if you haven't, I'm pretty sure everyone's freaking aware of Super Mario World and what it's about at this point. If you're not, then I don't know. very good game. This is actually my favorite 2D Mario game. I know, it's debatable between, you know, this and Super Mario Bros. 3 of which one's the best 2D Mario. But I personally like this one. This one's my favorite. The Super Mario Bros. 3, I suck at that one, so. Here is a dragon coin, actually. And, if you collect all 5 in each level, then... Okay. Shell. Work. Come on, Shell. Work. Anyway, so if you collect all 5, you'll get 1-up. 1-up is what I just got right now. It's an extra life. See, I don't know to explain. I don't know if I should explain everything. I'm pretty sure everyone has played Mario at least once in their lives, so I don't think it's worth explaining. But something different in Super Mario World is, come on, pan over. At the end of each level, you can cut these little strips right here, and you'll actually get a score. And once you get points, actually, and once the points reach 100, you'll be able to go into a bonus game. Highest points you can get is 50. Lowest being, I guess, 1. It goes from 1 to 30, and then 40, 50. And, yeah, well, I've only gotten 50, like, twice ever, so... Hopefully I can get it again in this Let's Play. I quite hope so, actually. Because 50, I mean, 50s are quite rare, you know? Yeah, so in this level, this is actually a yellow switch palace. And you just press P switch, you get a bunch of coins, you get a bunch of lives, and... It's all good, you know? So once I press this button here, this giant button, all the outline boxes will actually or the yellow ones at least, will turn into yellow sod block boxes, which those actually drop mushrooms every time you hit it. So no matter what, you know, power up you have, you'll always get a mushroom, which is good or bad, depending on, nah, actually it's kind of bad. Well, it's better than nothing, I guess. At least you get a solid block. There'll be more of those switches later on in the game of like multiple colors and whatnot. So grab the shell right here and get yourself a well-deserved 1-up. And here's a solid block we just unlocked, and we just got a mushroom, even though we have a fire flower. And hooray, we found Yo. She's been hiding in that box forever, hasn't he? But Yosh is pretty cool. You can beat his eyes and get his tongue stuck out, and eat stuff and fruits and enemies, and except for Chucks. You can't eat Chucks, which suck. These are charging Chucks. They're assholes. They're always going to be assholes. That's a midway point. So if you die, you actually spawn there. And if you already have a Yosh and unlock another one, like I just did. Yeah, it'll give you a 1-up instead, which is very nice. Oh, crap. Why'd I just do that? There we go. If you go up here, another dragon coin. I'm going to try to collect every single dragon coin, but it's really not important. Like, I just did with this level right now. I just got the last one. And we just got all the fruits. Or not all the fruits, but after a certain amount of fruits, Yoshi will shoot out a mushroom. But in this room... If you jump off Yoshi, you'll get a 1-up. And if you don't have Yoshi, you can throw these little blocks up there and do whatever. But I'm not gonna do that. You can also eat the blocks, apparently. I didn't know that. Well, you can. And, So yeah, it's not for 100% getting all the dragon coins, but if you so please, you may. Or I will. I'll try. I'm pretty sure I've never even gotten all of them before, but I guess I'll try my best. Try my hardest to get every single dragon coin. I've done it so far, so which is pretty good. And yeah, I'll try to do that. Oh, poop. Nope, I'm not interested in that mushroom. Nope, not taking that mushroom. Here's another Yoshi. You can get the 1-up if you still have your Yoshi like I do. Jump down here is a pipe. Quite well hidden, if I do say so myself. Remember to get this P-Switch and spit it over here, because you don't want to spit it on the lava. I've done that a few times and screwed myself over. Of a dragon coin, which you can only get by doing that. Here's the midway point. Another dragon coin. These first levels are quite easy. As you can see, I'm breezing through all of them. So, it does get quite hard, though. I will start dying a whole lot. I'm going to cut everything out. It's going to be crazy. But, yeah, it's kind of why I like this game. I've played it a lot, so, I know, I'd have some of this memorized, so that's probably why I'm not. I don't think I've gotten hit yet, have I? Damn, I'm probably going to. I mean, this is a good start, at least, you know. So far I'm doing good, which I'm happy about. And here we go, the first water level of the game, which isn't really a water level, which is weird. Like, it's half water. Like if you try, you'll actually never touch the water. But, what's crazy about this level, you can go down this pipe, and here, you went from water to, like, desert land, I guess, because of these Pokies here. And, if you don't have a Yoshi, these Pokies will be actually pretty small. But, since I have Yoshi, all these Pokies are humongous. And, alright, here's, like, an infinity, not really infinity, but there's a lot of coins you can get in here. There's no point of this room other than, just getting coins, I guess. That's like the only source of coins in this little part of the level. I really found it pointless. It's actually a death trap if you don't have Yoshi. It's not very fun, but I don't need that. Your shell. Oh, damn it. You can, come on. Jeez, this is gonna be the running thing in this Let's Play, isn't it? Hit the P-Switch and get the star and get all these Koops. These Koopas. These are called Koopa Troopas, by the way. Not the things I'm hitting now, but the turtles. I'm probably gonna be calling them Koopas. Get a couple 1-ups here. There you go. That's what I usually do. You can get quite a few lives doing that, really. And 24, okay. We're not gonna get 100 by the end of this episode, but maybe in the next episode I'll definitely get 100, and haha, I got 69. Oh my gosh. That was, I don't know if that was really lucky. I was gonna call it lucky that I got 69, but what are the odds of the points equaling 69? You know? So, if you hit this P-Switch and hit that, you'll be able to get the Fire Flower quite easily. Because otherwise, you would have a very difficult time trying to get that Fire Flower, or whatever power-up that was. Actually, if it's a mushroom, it was going to be probably pretty easy, because mushrooms move, which I don't understand in Mario at all. Why do the mushrooms move, but the flowers are planted? Which, well, I get the whole flowers are planted, but aren't mushrooms planted too? Like, why do the freaking mushrooms move around? Pretty stupid. And another thing that's really stupid is this thing right here. Not the flying box. I mean, this thing that I never knew what it was. I always thought it was like a brick of wax or something. You can actually cut in front of it. You can do whatever the hell you want. And I actually accidentally went in that door. Whatever. This is the first boss of the game. Iggy. Oh, what? Okay. Iggy. Fine. He's quite easy. Actually, I had a pretty hard time the first time around. For some reason, that boss is... There's easier bosses out there, and that boss isn't the easiest. That made no sense, but whatever. Now that we've rescued Yoshi's friend, because that's the point of this game, apparently. You gotta rescue all Yoshi's friends. And, Mario is a terrorist, and he likes to blow up all the Koopa castles, which isn't very nice, Mario. Very bad. And good thing we defeated Iggy Koopa. Because he's definitely not my favorite boss ever. But what? Nonetheless, we've defeated the first world. And we've made it to the second world. So in the next episode, guys, we'll take on the second world. And it's going to be quite fun. So hopefully I'll see you guys in the next episode.